I mean, I'm thinking armor, right? Armor or something.
Sven is quite physical heavy himself, though, against the Lich.
I feel like Sven would be very clumsy.
I think this is the worst mana burn I've ever seen on level 1. You mana burn a troll, he has 14 int. This is like the dumbest hero in Dota. And, you know, it doesn't really have that high of an impact.
You're offending Okamajai by doing that. KP on bottom lane, a little bit in trouble. GH actually able to get that first crush off. The body blocking from the trees. My control! You said if he had...
Lich has a very good eye for what works. At what times in the game and how he should move around, and that's in a position 4 player in this patch, that is like the highest quality you can have, is that game sense.
We have a lane switch, middle lane, courier snipe, mind control coming in for the kill on SCT. Miracle was already diving into the tower thanks to Nyx Assassin rotating towards bottom. Miracle and Kuro were not being punished for their dive. Mind control, however, might, but GH in the neighborhood. They're gonna look for the double crush at GH. He'll connect a double kill for mind control, and GH, he's trying to get in front of him, almost attempting to get just in the line of Kaka.
It's a better economic choice for Liquid to sacrifice mind control a little bit in this sense and then give the Lifestealer a better matchup against the Batman.
Open wounds on bottom, going after KP. GH has the crush available, waiting out a little bit longer. The maximum amount of control time on KP. The Firefly is cutting the trees, and Batman happy to walk through it. GH.
With this matchup, but you know.
We only have real players in this grand final center. In bottom lane, already Matumman going for another dive. KP has to take flight, but the open wounds will slow him down. GH is here. It's a secondary stun. That's all they want to hold him in position. KP will fall. And Team Liquid, apart
from even killing him top, maybe.
Boogie able to TP out. Mind control, they get the vision. And this was the only lane that was going.
Giving them that shaker just so you can get to play Dota.
They're coming to mid. They're going to try and punish Miracle at the moment. The quick rupture. Miracle still close to the T1 tower. Has to try and run it off. He's got a lot of life, but without a TP scroll, can't really go anywhere. Mind control wants to sprout control the hillside. By the time he finishes the farming up in the jungle, but mind control's up on this top lane, ready to pressure the T1 tower. Just like we saw previously, Moogie, he wants to rupture onto Batman, coming up in the tower. Here comes GH. It's the same gang over and over again. The frostbite's nice, but then again, the damage. Kaka can't turn for the stun and the infest. He's inside the creep, popping back out. Mind control will join the fight. Wrath of Nature damage has already been inflicted as GH, he's got sprint off cooldown in 2 seconds' time. This will give him the movement speed to catch up to Fate, especially when mind control holds him in this round. He's looking for the stun on Moogie. Kuro just lets the ulti go. They may, and yes, they do. They have enough damage to kill off Moogie, turning attention towards Faith falling for the second time.
But for the moment,
all they can do is try and pincer up GH. He's put an aggressive observer ward down so we get a little bit of extra vision. As the rest of Moogie do move over, he'll see Kaka. He'll end up seeing Moogie. GH, not sure how you get out this one. Top lane, the fight's been going in the meantime. Is KP dying, but GH runs off the rupture, so a 1-1 trade sandwich. That observer ward down once again. Two aggressive observer wards. You wouldn't even think you're 10 minutes into this game, but it reveals KP's position perfectly. So the crush can come in. KP, he can firefly and get up the hill. I say he can. He doesn't have the movement speed. Turning on the spot, almost like he's the one getting sticky napalmed up. Where's your detection? Is a sentry ward available for Kuro, but at least Kaka has this information. So here comes Nubi. You can blood right, you can find the control. Is Kuro getting caught out? SCCC, he has Laguna Blade. Doesn't want to burn it for just a Lich. He wants a call, but he's not going to live long enough. Matumman just arrived. There's so much damage. Even GH getting that follow-up stun onto KP. Firefly is available. He's now going to burn it. Lasso's up to the double stun from Kaka, creating space. They're looking towards Slaughter. Anchor the clipping is about to begin. GH unwillingly left on the hill. Where's the stun? Where's the control? GH just TP's out under the cover of Maul, not too far away. He wants to stay in the fight, so he only went towards the shrine and then back to the mid. But Tubberman with no mana and Moogie moving at very, very fast speed. This is the downside about not TPing all the way back to base. Moogie currently is going
and out of this map. Yep. Laguna Blake, go for a kill. They're going to find Tubberman, Kaka. Walking right over the top of him. Here goes your rupture to start with. Follow-up stun. Rage is available from the Life Sealer, but then again, when the silence is there, SCCC commits this time with a look.
So, Miracle has the info, and I don't think.
KP, five flight up. Miracle's the opportunity.
Oh, GH failed!
He didn't blink! He didn't get a crush! Now the double stun is in there from Kaka! Really catching Team Liquid on the back heels. Wrath of Nature bounces through, however, so at least they can get the leader back. But right now, two heroes down for either side. It's Faith on the run with Moogie down south away from Kuro. On mind control of the Tumberman, turn their attention towards Kaka. Another double stun from this Nyx Assassin.
and Team Liquid, they're going to be sad about this if they can't get more, and they're looking for it under the T1 tower. Boogie is here, ready to fight, but Tupperman stealing that life back, ready to fight up Kaka. Invis for the moment, they'll drop the sentry ward under the tower, Spike Carapace buying space for Kaka. They need more damage. Mind Control dusting out Kaka with a stick charge, still alive back under the tower. He'll survive, but Mind Control does his TP, nothing to cancel it, so he'll get out. Kaka stunned just a little
bit. GH. And that's an infested lifestealer as well. So lifestealer now gets blinked into the fight afterwards. And that was really awkward. So it ends up being a 2-for-2, clearly favoring newbie when you're this far behind. They catch up a little bit.
Oh, GH. He has a haste rune while being ruptured. This is the worst contradiction of abilities.
All right, newbie are showing signs of life in this game. This game could have already been completely out of control if it was not one of these top caliber teams. They're even going to find Kuro in mid. Another kill.
That they are. Able to bring down the Lich. Nature's Prophet, however, now with the Shadow Blade, he's become the Infest Bomb, working to bring down Moogie. Moogie doesn't have the life to survive this, trying to go left and right, but that's not gonna dodge you. The Tumberman and Mineground Vision the Team Liquid have around the pit. So they go for more defensive ward. Roshan's down to 2k. KP, he does have the Firefly. Blinkers up in 1 second time. 1 second will be perfect. But then again, the initiation's already happened. Faith letting it go. But Tumberman standing right in front, taking it at the same time. You've got SCC, a perfect stun. Troll Wall Lord's out. Kaka wants his TP. These Ancients are not his friends. That Lich ulti just would not stop the bounce, bounce, bounce. SCC, he's on the run now. From two heroes, about to become three for the third. Doesn't even arrive in time.
GH, that Invis rune can't toggle sprint without breaking it.
Oh, he's found a target.
Slowly but steadily just blow up.
Kaka's walked up. He doesn't have Invis available. And it really is a blow up.
On the ward. He's going to get this.
On the way back, he's got the damage. Sure. Get ready for res, everybody. Kaka, sign. Boom. Ton. 36 people are now happier.
41, I think. Oh, you got slightly happier as well.
Okay, babe. Liquid are just always together now. Five heroes, one infested inside the slaughter. Nyx Assassin gets some good vision now. Kuro, Miracle, and Mind Control, all visible. Kaka needs a good opening, but they've already lost KP. Ready to be bopped.
100 gold for Radiance. He got it there, that blood rate. He's just going to buy that and send it out to himself.
Waiting. He's holding onto his buyback. Nyx Assassin, he's the one being initiated on. Spike Cameras creates a little bit more space. Can't get the stun. The Laguna Blade does pop the slaughter, so at least amplification is gone. But Mind Control, with his own BKB up and running, has already beaten the crap out of the tower. Lifestealer stunned up from SCCCC, but he doesn't have enough damage. Without the Laguna Blade, they cannot pop that armor toggling Lifestealer. The Blood Rite will force Team Liquid play. Smoke. Oh, Nyx Assassin, again, great vision up from him. He'll come underneath the Dire Sentry Ward, and they'll see he misses the Burrow Strike, and now they jump in, hitting very hard. Slaughter so low, he will fall the lasso. They're pushing the Troll Ball on, up on the cliff. KP successful with that, while the Rupture on the backline's Mind Control. BKB won't protect you from this. Moogie, he's got the damage output, but not when he's getting Frost Blast down on 98p. Matoma needs to hit, able to do so. Three heroes lost.
But he was guessing for the Nyx. He didn't have the information. Misses the stun. They instantly kill him. Shrine even acting. Look at that. Maiden just gets two shot by Lifestealer.
Oh, we can come back live as Team Liquid pushing into the bottom lane. Troll Wall Lord. The dust is up. They have the vision. Laguna Blade's available. They're saving it. They don't need it to get this kill on Troll Wall Lord. And now it's Team Liquid on the run. GH is arriving, and so is Nature's Prophet. Infest up. They're going in once more. Blink looking for the crush. The Frostbite. Perfect coming from Faith. Creating space. There's still the Troll Warlord down. The Courier is the only thing for the Radiant side to die until Faith then follows it into the grave. Lifestealer, they got to keep that detection up. Sentry Ward is down. The Glimmer Cape of Kuro really causing problems for Newbie to commit in these detection items. But Matumberman, oh no, the Lincoln Sphere! He had it up. KP blinked in. He was looking for the Lasso. Lasso is the thing to trigger the Lincoln Sphere. And now it's four heroes down. I don't know if Newbie can really repel this. They may even lose SCCC. Mind Control DKB is protecting himself from the Life Strike Array. And now he'll die. The denial from the Bloodstone, but this is not the position Newbie thought they were going to have. They were the ones to get the initial kill. And now they're losing two lanes of Brax.
Liquid showing really good fighting understanding here. They lose the turnaround with the quick Infest play, and just understand that in this position they can win the fights 4-on-5 or 4-on-4 at the very least if the right abilities have been used. And that's going to be two lanes of barracks here.
Yep.
Toward the end of the quick game one. Unless Newbie pulled off some absolutely miraculous smoke play.
And
nope.
GG, Newbie, they know it's over. You've lost two lanes of Frax. Liquid showed the lower bracket matchup that they would hold their advantage. They would keep the split push going and bleed Newbie dry. Instead, Newbie tap out and pushes into game two.